Ensign rolled in for Rodriguez. Rodriguez able to find Ruy Diaz in there, swinging a miss. It almost fell free for Morris. Ruy Diaz a second time. Single to block. Morris the header. It bounces in.
Thanks to the hat trick by Jordan Morris Saturday afternoon, the Sounders are headed to the Western Conference semifinals after defeating FC Dallas 4-3. And the Rave Green will now host Real Salt Lake on Wednesday night for a spot in the conference finals.
Are you pumped?
We're so pumped.
We're so pumped we got our scarves ready. You better believe it. Michelle Ludka's in studio with a special guest and joins us now with more on this amazing Sounders playoff run, guys.
Looking good over there with the scarves, you guys. I'm here with Sounders General Manager Garth Lagerwey. Garth, thanks so much for taking the time, for stopping by and chatting with us. And congratulations to your organization for getting the win on Saturday.
Big win. Oh, three more
heart,
to go.
My heart only stopped, you know, a couple of times during that match. It was...
We made it exciting.
You definitely made it exciting. We'll talk about that in a minute. But we start with Jordan Morris. Just this morning, he was named the MLS Comeback Player of the Year. Garth, Jordan was your first homegrown signing from when you joined Seattle back in 2015. You signed him in 2016. How exciting and well-deserved is this award for Jordan and the club?
It's incredible. I mean, if just how hard he has worked to get himself back to this position. You know, when you think about people used to malign his left foot, his ability to finish with that off foot, and he went to rehab and he said, I'm going to come out with a better left foot than I did when I went in. So not only did he get stronger and more powerful, but he actually came out a better player. And that's a testament to how much effort and will that kid put in.
Well, and then just add what a wonderful human being he is off the field. I mean, with all of his work with type 1 diabetes, he's just truly incredible, well-deserved. But now tomorrow's game will be the third meeting for Seattle and RSL in the playoffs since 2009. Last time these two teams met, Garth, you were actually the general manager of Real Salt Lake. So now you're on the other side. What do you remember from, I guess, being with Salt Lake, taking on the Sounders those years ago?
I think they beat us once and we beat them once. And, you know, I got my theys and the wees back up now and who knows. But, look, it's two great clubs and we've obviously played some very good games against Salt Lake in the past. And really glad to be here and happy with what we've been able to accomplish so far in Seattle and hopefully able to get past Wednesday and make another run.
Does it add any extra excitement for you knowing both clubs so well? Obviously, rooting for the Rave Green tomorrow through and through. Let's get that one clear. But extra excitement?
You know, I know everybody over on the Salt Lake side still. So, I mean, those are my friends, and I have lots of friends here. And, you know, that part maybe is maybe personal, maybe more connection. But the good news is I don't have a lot of effect on the impact of this game tomorrow at this point. Like, our pencils have been down since September 15th at the roster freeze, and it's up to the players now. They're going to have to decide this thing out in the field, and we're looking forward to that at 7 o'clock on tomorrow night.
Absolutely, and tickets are still available for that, so let's pack the house. The game is set to kick off at 7:05, so get there early so you don't miss any of the action whatsoever. Garth, quick, before I let you go, Saturday was our first taste of the new playoff format. Were you happy with how it turned out? For those unaware, there's no aggregate two-game series anymore. It's single elimination games all the way through.
Look, I'm a fan of American sports, so I love it. I mean, this is the NFL model. I think that's arguably the most exciting playoffs in North American sports. And for us, everything gets crammed into one game. Even when we were up two goals against Dallas, they weren't going to go away. They were going to fight and come back, and it produced this incredible, epic game. You know, our game last year against Portland, I thought was an epic game if you took that second leg. So there's a ton of stuff that goes into this. Everything's at stake. It couldn't possibly be more important. And moreover, this format values the regular season. Mm-hmm. Us finishing second, having put in all that work in the regular season to get home field for this game, I think is huge. So I love it. I love the format.
And hopefully tomorrow we have just as exciting of a game with the similar outcome, Sounders coming out on top. But we'll have to wait and see. But yeah.
I'd even take a little less exciting, Michelle.
Oh, yeah, a little less. Finish it in regulation. No extra time. No shootout. We don't need any of that. We'll finish it in regulation. Garth, thanks so much for coming in. Really appreciate it.
Awesome. Thanks for having me.
Of course. Best of luck to the Sounders. Again, Sounders and Real Salt Lake. Semifinals, Western Conference tomorrow at 7 o'clock at 2nd.